Let us now consider how to calculate the earliest start time, the earliest start time, the earliest finish time, the latest start time, the latest finish time, and the slack using this diagram. We are going to consider how to calculate the earliest start time, the earliest finish time, the latest start time, the latest finish time, and the slack using this diagram. The way to go about it is through the forward pass to calculate the earliest start time. To calculate the earliest start time will be through the forward pass. We shall use the method of forward pass to calculate the earliest start time. For activity A, the earliest start time for activity A is going to be where activity A is originating from, which is this. For activity A, the earliest start time will be 0, which is this. So the earliest start time of each activity is going to be this circle. You can see how I have divided the circle into two. So for me to determine the earliest start time, I'm interested in this second part, in this left-hand part of all the circles. The left-hand part of all the circles, that's what I'm interested in to be able to determine my earliest start time. To be able to determine my earliest start time, I'll be interested in this, in the left-hand part of the circle. So for activity A, what I have in the activity A originates from this circle, and what I have in the left-hand side is 0. So therefore, the earliest start time for activity A is 0. For activity B also starts from this circle. So therefore, the earliest start time for activity B will also be 0. For activity C starts from this circle. Activity C originates from this circle. Therefore, the earliest start time for activity C will be 15. Activity D originates from this circle. Therefore, the earliest start time for activity D will be 12. Activity E originates from this circle. This is activity E. It originates from this circle. So therefore, the earliest start time of activity E will be 15. Activity F originates from this circle. Therefore, the earliest start time for activity F will be 12. Activity G originates from this circle. Activity G originates from this circle. This is activity G originating from this circle. Therefore, the earliest start time for activity G will be 18. Activity H originates from this circle. Therefore, the earliest start time for activity H will be 24. Activity I originates from this circle. Therefore, the earliest start time for activity I will be 23. Activity J originates from this circle. So therefore, the earliest start time of activity J will be 38, while activity K originates from here, and then the earliest start time of activity K will be 52. Having determined that, I can easily determine my earliest finish time. Having determined my earliest start time. My earliest finish time is simply the earliest start time plus the duration. My earliest finish time is simply the earliest start time plus the duration. So therefore, the earliest finish time for activity A equals the earliest start time, which is 0, plus the duration, plus 15. That's 15. For activity B, the earliest finish time is 0, earliest start time plus duration, 12, that's 12. For activity C, the earliest start time of activity C is 15. What is the duration of activity C? 3. That gives us 18. For activity D, the earliest start time is 12 plus the duration of D, which is 5, that gives us 17. For activity E, the earliest start time for activity E is 15 plus the duration of 8, that gives us 23. For F, earliest start time of F is 12 plus duration of 12 of F, which is 12, that gives us 24. For activity G, earliest start time of activity G is 18 plus duration of G, which is 5, That gives us 23. For activity H, earliest start time of activity H is 24 plus duration of H, which is 14, that gives us 38. Earliest start for activity I, earliest start time of activity I is 23 plus duration of I, which is 3, that gives us 36. For activity J, earliest start time of activity J is 38 plus duration of J, which is 14, that gives us 52. For activity K, earliest start time of activity K is 52, duration of K is 10, so therefore the earliest finish time of K will be 62. That's how to determine the earliest start time and the earliest finish time. Let's now go ahead to look at how to determine the latest finish time and the earliest latest start time and the latest finish time. To determine the latest finish time, I will now look into the activities near the arrow's end. I'm going to be considering this circle. I'm going to be considering where the arrows, the destination of the arrows, the right hand side of the circle where the arrow arrives. So for activity A, the earliest finish time of activity A, activity A finishes in this circle, and then to the right hand side of the circle is 16. So the earliest finish time of activity A is 16. The earliest finish time of activity B finishes here. The right hand side of activity B is 12. Earliest finish time of B becomes 12. For activity C finishes in this circle. What I have in the right side of the circle is 19. Activity D also finishes here. What I have in the right hand of D is also 19. Activity E finishes here. What I have on the right hand of E is 35. Activity F finishes here. What I have on the right hand of F is 24. Activity G finishes here. What I have here too is 24. Activity H finishes here. What I have on the right side of where activity H finishes is 38. Activity I finishes here. What I have in the right side of where activity I finishes is 38. Activity J finishes here. What I have on the right side where it finishes is 52. And activity K concludes here. What I have on the right side is 62. That's how to calculate the latest finish time. And then what I need to calculate now is the latest start time. The latest start time we shall calculate as latest finish time minus duration. So for activity A, the latest start time will be latest finish time, which is 16, minus the duration of 15, that gives me 1. For activity B, latest finish time is 12 minus duration of 12, which is 0. Activity C, the latest finish time is 19. The duration of C is 3. That gives me 16. For activity D, the latest finish time is 19. The duration of D is 5. That gives me 14. For activity E, the latest finish time is 35. Duration of E is 8. That gives me 27. Activity F, the latest finish time is 24. F is for 12 weeks. So therefore, the latest start time of F is 12. Activity G now. Latest finish time of G is 24. Duration of G is 5. that gives us 19. Activity H, latest finish time of H is 38. Duration is 14. That gives me 24. Activity I, latest finish time of I is 38. Duration of I is 3. That gives me 35. Activity J, latest finish time of J is 52. YJ, duration is 14. That gives me 38. While activity K, latest finish time of K is 62, duration of K is 10, that gives me 52. So this is how to determine the latest finish start time and the latest finish time. I can now put all this information in tabular form. So having put my earliest start time, my earliest finish time, latest start time, and latest finish time in tabular form according to the activities, I can now calculate the slack. I can calculate the slack, which is calculated as the latest start time minus the earliest start time. So that is the latest start time minus earliest start time. In this case, one, this gives me 1 minus 0, which is 1. 0 minus 0 gives me 0. 16 minus 15, that gives me 1. 14 minus 12, 2. 27 minus 15, 12. 12 minus 12, that gives me 0. 19 minus 18, 1. 24 minus 24, 0. 35 minus 23, that's 12. 38 minus 38, 0. 52 minus 52, that gives me 0. So you will realize that all these activities that give me 0, they are the critical parts. All the activities that I got 0 from are the critical parts. All the activities that give me 0 are the critical parts. If you go back to check, you realize that all the activities that give me 0 are the critical parts. So we move to project crashing. Activity crashing. In crashing activity, we realize that both time and resources are two important factors that must be considered in project in network model, because these two will need to be saved. If you remember the example we did, it was supposed to take us 62 weeks to complete the project. The duration of the project was 62 weeks. That has to do with time. And then each activity, everybody performing each activity will be paid. Everybody performing each activity will be paid an amount for as their wages. So therefore, these two activities, these two items are of importance to us so that we may be able to save them. In saving them, what we do is what we call project crashing. In an attempt to crash project, what we consider are only the critical activities. The critical activities are the only activities that we consider to crash, so that if you go back to the example, our duration in that critical activity, of that critical activity, for activity A, our duration was 12, activity F 12, H 14, J 14, K 10. If we decide to crash, and then this means the normal time or the normal duration that the project would have taken, we can encourage activity A that instead of finishing this work in 12 days, can you do overtime and finish in 10 days? The same thing, all these individuals may be encouraged that instead of finishing in the normal time, can you do overtime and finish in this time? And then, while you are working the normal time, this is the normal amount they are being paid. So if activity A finishes in 12 days, it's going to get 1,005. as his wages. If activity B finishes in 12 days, he's going to get 2,000 as his wages. But we now encourage activity A that if you can finish, if you can work overtime and finish in 10 days, we shall pay you 2,500 naira more than the normal wages you would have received. If activity F can finish in 9 days, say 3 days for us, we shall pay 3,200 instead of the normal 2,000. So for us to know which of the activities we shall focus on to crash, we need to know the cost and time ratio. Cost and time ratio, which is crash cost minus normal cost divided by normal time minus crash time. So for activity A, we have 2,000 minus 1,005 divided by 12 minus 2. That gives us 500 divided by 2. For activity A, that gives us 250. For activity B, we have 3,002 minus 2,000 divided by 12 minus 9. That gives us 1,002 divided by 3. That's 400. For activity C, we have 3,005 minus 2,005 all over 14 minus 13. That's 1,000 divided by 1. That's 1,000. For activity D, we have 4,000 minus 2,000 divided by 14 minus 10. That gives us 2,000 divided by 4. That's 500. For activity K, we have 4,000 minus 3,000 divided by 10 minus 9. That gives us 1,000 divided by 1. That gives us 1,000. Having done the cost time ratio and gotten this figure, the activity that will crash is the activity that's giving me the lowest figure of 250, which is activity A. Which means that if I crash activity A, I shall be spending 250 naira extra and saving 2 days. Which means that I will spend 250 naira extra and save 2 days. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you for listening.